We shall move to the next question. A pipeline having oil of specific gravity 0.87 changes in diameter from 200 mm at a position A to 500 mm at a position B, which is 4 meters at higher level. If pressure at A and B are 9.81 Newton per centimeter square and 5.866 Newton per centimeter square, and if the discharge is 200 liters per second, determine loss of head and direction of flow. This problem is a bit different from what we have been seeing earlier. Here, we have been asked to find out two terms. Head loss and direction of flow. Head loss and direction of flow. Before going deep into solving this problem, I wish to tell you certain things that we had already discussed in our class. Imagine that there is a pipe like this, and some fluid is flowing. Okay. Now in this pipe, there are two points, point A and point B. From Bernoulli's principle, the energy at A is equal to Pa by rho g plus Va square by 2g plus Za. And energy at B is equal to Pb by rho g plus Vb square by 2g plus Zb. So these are the energy equations. So the total energy at A will be equal to sum of total energy at A will be sum of pressure energy, kinetic energy and atom energy. And the energy at B will be equal to sum of pressure energy at B, velocity energy at B and atom energy at B. Okay, these are the energy equations. And from law of conservation of energy, Ea will be equal to Eb. Ea will be equal to Eb. Now this concept, that is Ea equal to Eb, is valid only for ideal fluids. That is Pa by rho g plus Va square by 2g plus Za equal to Pb by rho g plus Vb square by 2g plus Zb. This is valid only for ideal fluids. I hope you all remember the assumptions that we took while finding out the Euler's equation of flow, and from there finding out the Bernoulli's equation. Euler's equation, Bernoulli's equation, the assumptions. And one of the assumptions was the fluid is ideal. So this is valid only if the flow is ideal. We know that all the fluids are real. Ideal fluid means a fluid which is having zero viscosity. That is actually an imaginary case. In reality, all fluids have some viscosity, and because of that, the energy available at A will not be equal to energy available at B, because while flowing through the pipe, some energy will be lost due to viscosity as friction. Some energy will be lost as the fluid reaches B from A due to viscosity and due to friction. So for a real fluid, this won't be the case. The equation will be like this: Pa by rho g plus Va square by 2g plus Za equal to Pb by rho g plus Vb square by 2g plus Zb plus head lost. So this will be the case for a real fluid. This is like representing 100 equal to 80 plus 20. So this 20 will be the loss of energy. So at A, 100 units may be present. At B, only 80 units may be present, and the 20 units will be lost during this transition, during this movement from A to B. So you have to remember that. So what is head loss? Head loss is the loss in energy that a fluid flow experiences when it reaches one point from another one. So always remember, this equation is, or this concept is valid only for ideal fluid. For real fluid, this will be the equation. Pa by rho g, Vba square by 2g plus Za equal to Pb by rho g plus Vb square by 2g plus Zb plus head loss. So if in a question they ask you to determine loss of head, you have to consider the flow as a real flow. You must consider the flow as a real flow or a real fluid. You have to take the fluid as a real fluid. Okay, so that is the first thing that you have to remember. So if you take this equation, there is no head loss term, so you will get stuck. So remember, if the question is to determine loss of head, you have to take this equation, you have to consider the fluid as real fluid. Okay, so that's the first part. Then they have asked to find out the direction of flow. In order to find out the direction of flow, you have to find out the energies at two points. Here, let us consider A. Here, consider it's A and B. So, you have to find out the energies at A and B. And the direction will be from point of higher energy to point of lower energy. So the flow always happens from a region of higher energy to region of lower energy. Then only this condition will be satisfied. The flow always happens from a point of higher energy to lower energy. So this concept I didn't tell during our lectures. So remember, the direction of flow always happens from a region of higher energy to lower energy. So these are the two concepts that you need to remember while solving this problem. So if the question is to find out loss of head, you have to consider the fluid as a real fluid and take this equation. And the direction of flow, you have to remember the flow direction always happens from a region of higher energy to